And we're live.
Welcome. Thanks for joining. Today we're going to discuss managing your meeting rooms efficiently and working with facility tasks. So welcome everyone. Today, first a few housekeeping rules before we start. So please post your questions on the community link and we will try to answer them within the demo, or otherwise, if you post them afterwards, we're gonna answer them afterwards. So know that this live broadcast becomes on-demand video immediately. So as soon as we finish, you can actually watch it back. You can share it with your colleagues at any time. So also, if you think this might be of interest with your colleagues, share this page with them. So make sure if you're watching this recording, please post your questions below for the experts and other community experts to answer, so that me or my colleagues can answer them, and you can just join the community for free. So this is really easy to do. So that's for the housekeeping rules. Today, first I'm going to give a short introduction about myself and Platformation, the company who created this Rooms for You application. Then we're going to discuss Rooms for You shortly, so which components are there and what can you do with Rooms for You. And then we're going to go into the hands-on live demo, in which I'm going to show you how Rooms for You works and how you can work with facility tasks efficiently and easily. Afterwards, there's time for question and answers, like I said, so please post your questions on the community. So I'm your presenter. I'm Annemarie Santiago. I'm a senior platform consultant at Platformation. I'm also the product owner of a couple of our applications, most of them in the facilities, and I'm a ServiceNow certified trainer. Also, I've done a couple of Rooms for You implementations and facility implementations, so this is really my area of work and expertise. The company I work for, Platformation, has created the Rooms for You application. So a little bit about Platformation. We are a company based in the Netherlands and Belgium. We have about 82 consultants working for us, and we have a customer satisfaction of 9.3. So we are really proud of that. And what we're also really proud of is that we're actually the first ServiceNow Triple Gold partner globally. So that's in the authorized training partner, gold services partner, gold technology partner, and gold sales partner. So that's something we're really proud of. Although we're based in the Netherlands and Belgium, we have customers worldwide that either we do implementations for or that use the Rooms for You app or one of our other applications. So as you can see, these are global companies such as ASICS, Eridato, Lamp Weston, Randstad, ING, for instance. So, about the Rooms for You suite, because that's why you're here, of course. So, Rooms for You allows you to reserve your meeting space in just a few clicks, either via your mobile phone or via your desktop. Also, and that's where I want to dive in a little bit more, because of course you can reserve meeting rooms, but I also want to show you how you work when you're a fulfiller, for instance, with these meeting spaces, with a catering request that's come from it, or with visitors that have been announced. So what can you actually do in ServiceNow to work more efficiently? So let's first talk about Rooms for You. Rooms for You has multiple components, and there are actually five of them. Only three of them I can show in this demo. So we have the widget, and that's actually the application that we have in ServiceNow. So the widget allows you to create your meeting room reservations in ServiceNow and see which reservations you've already made and to request catering. More about that later. We also have the Exchange interface, and the Exchange interface actually synchronizes ServiceNow with Exchange. Also a little bit more about that later on as well. Then we have the Visitor and Catering add-in, and the Visitor and Catering add-in is an add-in for Outlook. And in this Outlook add-in, it helps you finding the meeting room that best fits the meeting purpose. So this is also something that I will show in the demo. Two other devices, the mobile and Book Now device, I cannot show you that because these are physical devices, but I will tell you a little bit about that later on. So about the widget, the widget I'm going to show in the demo, and this is your go-to place if you're working in ServiceNow and you want to find which meeting rooms are available. So you can reserve specific meeting rooms. You can actually apply a filter if you're looking for a specific room, such as a room where you can give trainings or job interviews. Besides of reserving your meeting room, you can actually also order with your meeting room reservations technical support, for instance, AV support, or amenities such as a catering, like water or lunch. And this you can order for your meeting room reservation. Also, being an administrator in ServiceNow or a fulfiller, it's really easy to also maintain that data. So that's something I want to show you as well. So how actually easy it is to set up these rooms that can be reserved in ServiceNow, and how you can define which kind of catering or which kind of support is available for each room. Then we have the Exchange integration, and the Exchange integration actually ensures that whatever you do in Exchange is also reflected in ServiceNow, also creates catering tasks in ServiceNow if you make a reservation with catering in Exchange, and vice versa as well. So if you create your reservation in ServiceNow, it will also be sent to Exchange. So these are always in sync, meaning that you can decide yourself whether you want to make your reservation in ServiceNow or in Exchange, or maybe even both. It's all up to you. The systems make sure that the integration actually makes sure that they are synchronized. So then the third application that we have, it works together with the Exchange integration and Rooms View, the widget, is the visitor and catering add-in. So this runs in Outlook, and it helps you actually to find the room that's available, but also actually to see, okay, what does this meeting room look like? Is this appropriate for the meeting purpose that I have? You can then select your room and order catering to it, but also announce visitors. So for instance, if you have a meeting with people that are external to your company, you can, with one press of the button, you can make them basically send them as visitors to ServiceNow. And then when they're in ServiceNow, you can, for instance, use them for your reception so that the reception knows what visitors to receive today. Then we have the mobile. So the mobile application has the same functionality as the application in ServiceNow. So what you can do in the widget, namely reserve meeting rooms or view what which meetings are upcoming, or even to request catering for your meetings, canceling your meetings. This is all available on mobile as well. And both on mobile and desktop, we have a really nice functionality, which is maybe even more relevant for mobile. Because when you have your meeting, but are not sure where in the building that meeting room is, you can click on your meeting and say show location. So when you click on show location, your meeting room is highlighted in a heat map of the building where that meeting room is. So you won't get lost anymore. Then we have the Book Now devices. So these are optional, but with the Book Now devices, you can hang them on the meeting room. And when they're on your meeting room, you can actually see whether the meeting room is free or not, or that it's reserved by someone else, or maybe by yourself. So you can check into your meeting rooms, which allows you to make sure that that meeting room is really reserved for you. If you don't check in, for instance, you can say, well, then the meeting is canceled and it's free for someone else to occupy. And also, it allows you to, when you are at a meeting room that's available, you can actually press the Reserve Now button and create an ad hoc meeting. So you don't even need to go to ServiceNow or to Outlook. You can just make the reservation right there from the device with one click on the button. And of course, because we all have all the data coming from your room reservations and everything that connects with it, such as your amenity requests and your visitors. Because we have that all in ServiceNow, you can report over that. So using the report mechanism of ServiceNow that ServiceNow has out of the box, you can get really insights in your meeting room reservations and your visitors or your catering requests, for instance. So that's just an overview of the components of the Rooms View applications. So now I would like to actually show you how that all works. In the demo, I will first create a room reservation in ServiceNow so that you have an idea how that works for end users, basically. Then I'm going to create a room reservation from Outlook, also using the add-in so that I can actually add catering to my meeting room reservations. Then I'll spend a little bit of time of walking you through how you get the app from the store basically in your own instance. So what the steps are from seeing it in the application store in ServiceNow to getting it running in your own instance. And lastly, I will quickly dive into the tasks, working with the task and the reports, because this is a question I get a lot. So when you have created a meeting with catering, how does the catering department, for instance, know that catering needs to be delivered in a meeting room? Also about reports, what kind of reports are delivered out of the box? So I'll be switching to the live demo instance then. Probably need to sign in and out again, because there is a timeout session. I think it's good right now. Okay, so we are in our demo environment. Let's just go to the homepage. And typically, what we see is that you can get to the app, to the Rooms View application via two ways. So in this window, we're seeing the backend, and we can just easily go to the application by typing in room or room reservation, which gives us access to the whole application in ServiceNow. So by clicking room reservations, we actually go to the view to actually make a reservation. And what you typically see is that that customers have a self-service portal. So for instance, this is a demo portal, and that they have a button to create a room reservation. So if I click on room reservation, this opens a widget in the page. And meaning if you're familiar with the service portal or widget, if you want, you can put this widget on any page you like. You can also even decide to put this widget on, for instance, the homepage if you want. So for now, we have it in our own dedicated reservations page. This is basically the same page as is shown here. And I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna create a reservation. So in the left, what we see here is my reservations, and it already shows the reservations that I made to today. I can easily filter on that. So if I'm looking for a board, for instance, I can see the meetings which have board in the reservations subject. So for now, I'm just going to click on the plus button to create a new reservation. And in this window, I can actually choose the date that I want to make the reservation for and the time. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to create a reservation for today. And with this these two circles, I can actually set the time. So this one is from 7 to 8. I can just drag and drop the letter one to expand the time or the first one. So I'm going to make a reservation for, let's say, 1.5 hours. And I'm going to choose room A301. Please note that I'm now ordering the rooms from A to Z. I can also deselect it, and then it will show the best fitting meeting room on top. So why does it put A701 on top? Well, for the attendees of this presentation looking really carefully, you may have seen this icon here, and this means I'm looking for a room with capacity of 2. I can also look for rooms with a capacity of 4 or even more. So it actually shows the best fitting meeting room on top. So if I'm looking for a room with capacity of 2, it shows a 701 because that has a capacity of 4. But if I look more below, I can actually see that the bigger rooms are shown at the bottom. And this is really to make sure that you use your meeting room space as efficiently as possible. But I am really a fan of room A301, so I'm gonna ignore this. To be honest, this one, A301, is actually connected for the demo, so that's why I'm choosing A301, but please don't tell anyone. So I'm clicking on A301, and in my confirmation screen, it confirms me the time that I've selected. It shows a picture of the meeting room. So this is also really easy to manage yourself, the picture and the description of the meeting room, because you can really easily set this up in when configuring the room. So this is all data driven. You can configure this yourself. So when I scroll down, I can actually see which fixed amenities are in the meeting room. So that's a conference video and the TV. And I can also decide to add some catering to my meeting. Well, and the meeting is from 7 to 8:30. So I might need some drinks and food. So I'm going to go ahead and order some catering. So in this specific meeting room, there are two types of amenities available, which is coffee. Well, I'm definitely going to take some coffee because it's quite a late meeting. And I'm going to order some luxury lunch. So this is, let's do 4 because I think we are quite hungry. The available catering is also something that you really can manage yourself very easily in ServiceNow. So this is all data driven. So I'm going to just say, well, this is a creative meeting with dinner. I can make it on behalf of someone else. So for instance, I can select my colleague Selassie, but for now I'm just going to create the meeting for myself. And if I click save, it's now saved to ServiceNow, but also to the room calendar. So that's of A301. So this is the meeting that I just created. So it's saved in Exchange in that meeting room, but it's also been added to my own personal calendar in Outlook. So it's there as well. So this is the flow from ServiceNow. There are much more functionalities there, but this is just to give you an overview of what Rooms View is. So if you look at our website or the store in ServiceNow, you can actually see that there are many more functionalities there. Now let's go to Outlook. I closed my Outlook because normally during demos you should keep this closed, but now I really need it for the demo, so I'm opening it. And I'm going to my calendar because we're going to create a meeting room reservation. So basically we're going to create a meeting. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm just doing what I would normally do when setting up a meeting. So I select the time, select new meeting request. So far we're just using Outlook out of the box functionality, and I'm gonna invite my colleague Selassie for the meeting, and also someone who's not in my company. She happens to have the same name as I do, annemariesantiago@gmail.com. I'm gonna create the meeting subject right here. So this is where the Rooms for You add-in comes in, because you see a couple of icons here. So this is basically the icon to open the add-in. So I click the icon there and it loads the add-in. So if I click now find room, it opens up a pop-up with all the rooms that are available at the time that I've selected. So from 1 to 2, as you can see. So most of the rooms are free. If they are not free, it doesn't show up in the list. I can easily filter on them. So for instance, if I look for rooms that have a Beamer and I click search, I see that only one room has a Beamer. So I'm now gonna clear the filter and I'm just gonna go ahead with room, well, I think a 3:01, but just let me quickly change the time because I wanted to have a little bit later. So I'm going to go to room A301, select room. So as you can see, the room has now been added to the add-in, but has also been added to the location field and the to field. So I'm going to add some amenities there because it's a lunch meeting. So I'm going to add that luxury lunch that's available there, 2 sandwiches and 2 coffee for me and Sadassi. I suffer from celiac disease, unfortunately. So I'm going to add for gluten-free, please. And then Selassie will also get gluten-free sandwiches. Then I have ordered my lunch and my coffee. Now I'm going to click the announce visitors button. And what happens here is that the system automatically detects, the add-in detects, hey, annemariesantiago@gmail.com, she is from a different domain than the host. Because Selassie and I work at Platformation and this is a different domain. So the add-in sees that as a visitor. So it automatically pre-fills already the name. I can modify that if I want to. And well, maybe she doesn't work at Gmail, but at Google. And I have some additional options, such as VIP, parking, and Wi-Fi. So if I select these things, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then this data will be sent to ServiceNow, and you can make any logic on that in ServiceNow. For instance, send out a notification to the parking department, or maybe send a notification to the visitor who's a VIP with a special welcome email. You can all create that yourself based on the data that will be sent to ServiceNow. So I'm going to go ahead and save my meeting facilities now, and I'm going to send the invitation. So at this moment, this information now is in Outlook, in my personal calendar, in the meeting room calendar, and in ServiceNow. This is basically the flow. So from the front end to create a reservation, also in Outlook. So we saw the add-in there, where you can add your meeting room, your amenities, and your visitors. But how does that look like for the backend? So in the backend, I have my reception dashboard, for instance. So the visitors that are announced, instance via the add-in, are showing up in today's arrivals. So as you can see, Annemarie from Google is not there, but that's because this only shows today's arrivals, because that's what's relevant for a reception desk. But if the meeting would have been for today, Annemarie would be here in the list today. So we have John Smith, Brad Bradley, and Luke Langley coming up. So if I select that John Smith is actually standing here at the reception desk, can actually even print badges for John Smith, and it automatically generates a badge, which I can print and I can hand out. I can also say that John Smith has now arrived. So John Smith will be put into the in-house visitors list. So this really helps the reception to manage the visitors quite easily. Then for the amenity request, so the catering actually, all this data is sent to ServiceNow. So the amenity requests actually show up in a list with the requested amenities. So we see our coffee, we see lunch. Well, if we scroll down, we can see the meeting for the 16th of July, and I actually can see my luxury lunch and my coffee. So this is really easy because you can make sure that however your catering department works, you can create a scheduled report and send that to them daily. You can give them access to this list so that they can work with it, or you can even make sure that they work from this on their phone and see daily which tasks they have on their phone and complete it from there. So that's it for making room reservations in ServiceNow and in Outlook. So now let's quickly look at how you would get such an application from the ServiceNow store to your instance, because I get some questions about that as well. So I'm just going to look for rooms for you in the store, and I can actually see my rooms for you components here. So this is rooms for you, the widgets. This is the visitor and catering add-in, and the rooms for you integration. So if I click on Rooms for You, you will see a button Request App. So if you request the app, it will be made available for you. And if you then go to your instance application, it may take a couple of hours before it is requested, because of course there are some licenses involved and payments. But when it's available, you can go to your applications. So where is it? Yeah, applications. And then it will be there right under the downloads. So if you can just bear with me for a second. Yep. So as you can see, we have lots of apps installed. But as you can see, Rooms for You shows up here in the list of downloads. We already have it, so we have an update button. But if you just purchase it, it's there with the install button, as you can see, for another application that we have. Then when you have installed Rooms for You, so you've hit the install button, we're going to set up Rooms for You. And that's quite easily, because as I said, most of the functionality is data driven. For instance, if we have our room here, so let's just go to a specific room. So room A301, for instance, you can actually see that room A301 has two types of amenities available. These two types of amenities I have configured in the rooms. So when you start with Rooms for You, one of the things you're gonna configure is are the rooms. So basically, you're gonna set up the rooms that are available for reservation. So for instance, you can see the same rooms here as I showed you in the widget. So if we click on room A301, we can actually see the description that we got in the confirmation screen here. And the static amenities that are there, for instance, TV and conference video. So these two actually show up here too. If I remove or add something in the room, TV or conference video, it will also be added or removed right here. Just going to make my screen a little bit bigger to make sure that you all see properly. I was about to say about the amenities. So if I scroll down, I can actually see which amenities are available in that room. So for this one, there's luxury lunch and coffee. But if I hit the edit button, I can actually make more available. Let's say an extra projection screen, or let's say tea is available there. So let's go ahead and save that. So the sharing, okay, you can click save and then do this again. So let's go to room A301 again. There, and if I go to my flexible amenities, then suddenly I see that that extra projection screen is available. And for catering, I actually have tea now available as well. So that's how easy it is to set up your rooms. Of course, there are more functionality there, but this is to give you an idea how easy it is to just configure your rooms, basically. One last thing I'd like to show you is the heat map that we have. So I'm going to zoom out a little bit more. Some people really like visuals. And they want to select their room from a floor plan, and that's absolutely possible with the app. So if you hit the building icon, it actually shows you the availability of rooms based on a heat map. So I can see that both levels are free. If I click them, I can actually see that most rooms are free, not the red one. So if I click that room, I'm also in the confirmation screen to reserve that meeting room. So that's quite easy as well. How you add these floor maps, floor plans, for instance, is just by going to the floor and adding a picture of that. So that's no complex business with AutoCAD images. It's just a PNG or a JPEG, for instance. Okay, we went through creating a room reservation in ServiceNow via the widgets. I also showed you how that was done in Outlook, including the add-in. Then we quickly glanced at how you get the application from the store to ServiceNow. So the ServiceNow store, and then request the app in ServiceNow. And we also took a little bit of a little peek inside how to set up the rooms. So you can set up your rooms, your floors, and your buildings. And the same goes for static amenities, for instance, the amenities that you can show that are available in a room, for instance. So that's just a quick overview of the Rooms View application. One last topic before we close the session today, it's the reports. So out of the box, the application comes with a couple of reports. There are many, many more reports possible, and it really depends on what brings value for your company, which kind of information. But you, for instance, can see which are the peak meeting hours during the day during the last month. So we can actually see that at 4 o'clock, we have the most meeting rooms requested. We also have insight in data which meeting room is occupied the most and which one are occupied not so much. So if, for instance, someone has a question saying, yeah, we need more meeting rooms, you can actually see, well, we don't need more meeting rooms. We just need to make sure that the meetings are reserved more efficiently, basically. Other reports, for instance, are reservations by source. So do people reserve via Exchange or via the desktop or even mobile, because you can make reservation via mobile as well. And so we have a couple of reports that just give you some insights into your meeting room usage. So let me go back to the presentation here. So we have just done the room reservations in ServiceNow via Outlook. We quickly glanced at installing the app from the store and setting up rooms for you. Also working with tasks, so we saw the overview of amenity requests that were made, and we quickly glanced at the reports that are possible. So we saw the first three components there in action: the widget, the Exchange interface, and the visitor and catering add-in. If you want to look at how the mobile and Book Now device works, I recommend you to Google on Rooms for You Platformation, and you will find some videos that show you how it works. So if there are any questions posted in the community, I'm happy to answer them. So Lisa, do you have any questions for me?
I don't see any questions at this time on the live chat version, but of course we can always answer the questions on the community after you post them so other users can see your questions and the answers.
So yes. Yeah. So please feel free to post your question there. Also, if you're looking at this video on demand, so later on, and you have some questions, feel free to post them.
Thanks so much.
Okay. Thanks, Lisa.